First, determine the center line horizontally. Horizontal center line here, and strike it with a marking gauge all the way down. Then establish the margins. In this case, I wanted half-inch margins top and bottom. So set the gauge at a half-inch, obviously, and strike those margins. Now, if you notice on the pattern that I've already got laid out, I have quarter-inch increments going all the way up. So drop in a quarter of an inch each side and strike those margins until you get, let's see, there's the half inch margins. I'm dropping in a quarter of an inch for this space here. I have a half inch space for this arc, so I don't need to put a quarter in the middle of that, just half inch and then quarter, quarter. I have my center line. I go quarter inch on either side of it. And then, of course, whatever I did here, I repeated on the other side. So top and bottom are exactly the same. Then at that point, determine the center so you can get a vertical center line. And in this case, this side is 9 inches. So 4.5 is my center. Going to go ahead. Typically, I will set this up with a an awl, but for the purpose of this video, I'll do it with a pencil so you can see it. So I strike a center line all the way through. Now, I want 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches. Okay, I'm dividing this up. Now I have my dividers are already set at quarter of an inch because I also want to subdivide those into 1/4 inch spaces. So I'll just take the dividers, walk myself across this board all the way to one side, 1/4 of an inch at a time. Little points, do them, come back in the other direction, now go ahead and count them. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 spaces. There's my 2-inch spot. 1, 2, 8. There's my other 2-inch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Now, go ahead. And my 2-inch spot, 2-inch spot. Okay, now go ahead and run all of these 1/4-inch lines. Now, if you're using an awl, you want to be careful not to go all the way. In other words, as you see here, I went through this arc, so I've got these striations through there. They'll sand out, of course, but depending on how deep you go with the awl, it may not. So, but for this pencil, I can definitely sand it off, so I'll just take it all the way. Just work your way across here, laying out all these lines. change it in the other direction. I can hardly see. And there you go. Quarter of an inch all the way across. Okay. Obviously right here is the center line. Actually right here is the center line. Okay. That's where the circle will be laid out. I've already got the compass set at 5/8 of an inch for an inch and a quarter circle. So I'll go ahead and scribe that now. Here is the center line. Okay. Now, you can see that, but it's definitely there. Highlight it with a pencil a little bit. It's there like that. Then at this point, all we have to do, there's our line, our edge right here. So we know we want to go over a quarter, up a quarter, and over a quarter. Okay? So over a quarter. Down here, over a quarter, up a quarter, over a quarter. Got a little too high right there. Let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of that. There we go. That'll go away. All right. Over, up, over. And then that starts our arc. On this side, we go here, over, up, over. And that starts our arc. Over, up, over. Over, up, over. Come to the next one line, 2-inch line here, 2-inch edge. Over, up, over. Over, up, over. Okay, now 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces for our arc. That's going to go up to this quarter inch line. Where did it go? I can't even see it. Right here. There will be your arc there. An arc there. And it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this needs to go over, down, and over. 1, 2, 3, 4. Over, down, over. Arc. There's the arc. Okay. The other side of that band, I'm going to start here, it's over, down, over. Middle there, you've got room for two quarter inch spaces, and that's going to be your inside of that arc. Okay, do that on both sides and then you connect the middle. But looking at what I had on the other side, is this connects to the circle. This is going to go all the way across. This goes all the way across. And this is going to drop down to the quarter inch line above the center line, where I will put that. And it goes on down from there. Boom. 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 this other way, and half inch. I can see it. There it is, right there. And drop down again. So that's basically how you lay out for the strap work. And then of course you come back with your gouges and make your gouge strings.